Last summer, I had my first exposure to a cicada killer wasp. I shared that on YouTube. This August, I was more prepared. The sandy soil of a nearby golf green was apparently a favored site for building wasp tunnels. The exit mounds were very obvious, and I did not have to wait very long for the action. At least four wasps were active on the green. There was much coming and going. I was surprised to see more than one wasp enter a burrow. I do not know whether individuals were male or female, and that may make all the difference. The next day, it appeared that a single wasp was tending at least two burrows at a time. These were big critters. I placed an available object nearby to allow a comparison. You can hear cicadas and tree frogs in the background. This is a faked shot. I have not yet actually filmed the entombment of a cicada. However, this gives a relative comparison of sizes. If this one was a sheep, you would say it was grazing. In actuality, it was looking for a place to start a new hole. When it found a place to break through the turf, it really went to town. I watched it for a while until it got too dark. It appears to use its abdomen to give it leverage in pressing ahead through the soil. Right after this, I had to give it up for the night. The next morning, around 9, I went back to survey the considerable damage to the putting surface. Even despite the watering, there were sizable mounds, and the wasps were not done yet. The ants were doing a pretty good job on my cicada, too. I managed to get some good footage and great still photographs, which I placed at the end. Watch how she handles the dirt. She throws soil backwards under her body with her front pair of legs, and then pushes it back further with her rear pair. All the holes were angled to the south, such that the mid-morning sun shone into the chamber she was enlarging at the bottom. I do not believe this orientation was for illumination, and I will speculate later. When this wasp's burrow seemed finished around noon, she began a series of approaches from the air as though she was memorizing its location. Each pass, she would start further out on the glide slope until she was well up in the nearby trees. She was flying out of the sun. I wondered if this approach was relevant to the orientation of her burrow. It was a hard night and day's work. It didn't seem to bother the two wasps that I was observing, no matter how close I got. Listen for the buzz of her wings as this wasp takes flight. You will soon see a sequence of three photos that illustrates the passage of a bolus of dirt from aft to stern. You will see the throw of dirt from the front legs in this next shot. I could not film the money shot in this sequence. I sat for over an hour in the hot sun, waiting for Wasp Woman to bring home her paralyzed cicada prey. I promise to keep trying. Until next time, happy hunting.